Hey guys, I'm Chandni and you're watching The Art of Science. Today, I'm all set to blow your minds away. First, I'm going to dazzle you with a mind-reading math trick. And then, I'm going to pull the curtain and reveal how the trick is done. I'm going to do this with some of my co-workers and my friends. So make sure you join as well and let's get started. Are you guys ready? Are you ready?
Yes.
So Astha, are you ready?
Yes.
Devanshi, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. First, think of a number. Okay. Now, I want you to double the number. So multiply it by 2.
Done.
Now, I want you to add 8 to this number.
Done.
Okay. Now, divide this number by 2. Okay. Now, subtract your original number from this number.
Yes.
Done?
Yes.
Okay. Now the final number that you've gotten, just keep the spelling of the number in your head.
Yes.
Okay. And now from the last alphabet of the number, think of a color.
Done.
From the last alphabet of the color, think of a country.
Got it.
Okay. From the last alphabet of the country, think of an animal.
Yes.
Done?
Yes.
Okay. From the last alphabet of the animal, think of a fruit. I know what you're thinking of. You are thinking of an orange.
Oh my god, how did you get it? You guessed it right.
Did you think of it?
Yes.
Alright, let me read your mind in 3, 2, 1. You are thinking of an orange.
Oh, you got me right.
Yes. Are you thinking of orange?
How did you know?
If you also thought of orange and if I guessed your answers right, make sure you drop in a yes in the comment section below. So what do you think this is? Is this hypnotism? Is it mind reading? It's actually maths and science, guys. That is true, guys. It is actually maths and science. I'm pretty sure that you must have come across this trick or something similar in school, college, and even online. And I'm also pretty sure that on listening to this trick, you might have been completely shocked and in thought that how did they get the answer? How? So today at dArtofScience, we are going to understand exactly how that happens. We are going to understand how this trick works. And once you do understand that, you will be able to make your very own versions of it. And the best part, win every time. So, to understand that, first we are going to start with the mathematical part of it. We are going to use algebra to bust this trick. First, I asked you to pick a number. Now, you could have picked anything, so we will keep this number as x. The next step was to multiply this number by 2, so this gives us 2x. Third step, add 8. This equals 2x plus 8. Fourth step was to divide the entire number by 2. So 2x plus 8 divided by 2 gives us x plus 4. And finally, I asked you to subtract your original number from your existing number. And this gives us x plus 4 minus x, which is 4. Maths is so beautiful, guys. Just look at that. The way this algebraic equation is structured, it just makes sure that no matter what number you pick, it will lead everybody to the same inevitable conclusion, which is the digit 4. Notice that in the series of steps, there is also multiplying by 2 and dividing by 2. This is called an inverse function. An inverse function in mathematics means operations that undo each other. Here, multiplying and then dividing by 2 are inverse operations, bringing you back to your starting point. But another important point is after multiplying by 2, I asked you to add 8. Then when I asked you to divide it by 2, the 2x went back to x, but the 8 got divided by 2 and became 4. Finally, on subtracting the original number, you were left with 4. Isn't this crazy, guys? So just like this, you could also make your very own algebraic equation, like I have. So now we are going to see another algebraic equation, an example, and also the mathematical working of it. Think of any number. Now add 5 to this number. Multiply this number by 3. Now, minus 15 from your number. Divide this by your original number. Now, add 7 to this. And your answer is 10, isn't it? You see, by this mathematical working, your answer will always be 10. Now that you're armed with the secrets of this trick, why don't you make and share your own? Dive into the comments and challenge each other with new puzzles. Now let's move on to the second part of the trick, where we navigate from numbers into thoughts. You see, the trick very smartly steers you into making predictable choices by asking you the right questions. It's not just about maths, but it's also about understanding the common patterns in the way humans think. We started with the letter R, which was the last alphabet of the number 4. I asked you to think of a color from the letter R. The most common color with R is red. The other colors that start with R are extremely rare and not even heard of, while some other ones are adjective based, like royal blue or rustic green. So it was inevitable that you would make the choice of red. And once I knew that you had thought of red, I asked you to think of a country with the last letter D. There are only 6 countries with the letter D, and 5 of them are rarely heard of. So the most common and the obvious answer that you might have thought of would be Denmark. Then I asked you to think of an animal with the last letter, which is K. And you guessed it right again. Obviously, out of killer whales and kodaks and koalas, the most commonly heard of that pops into your brain first is going to be a kangaroo. And the final step was to think of a fruit that starts with an O. Now come on guys, tell me honestly, how many fruits do we even know that starts with the letter O? Of course it had to be an orange. But of course, there are many outliers as well. There must have been people who thought different words at different points in the question. So if you are one of them, make sure you leave your chain of answers in the comment section below. The concept here is a blend of mathematics as well as psychological patterning. The mathematical part of it uses algebraic equations to guide you to a predetermined outcome. And then the psychological patterns leverages upon common associations and probability to predict your choice of words for animal, country, color, and so on. This combination doesn't just reflect upon the principles of algebra, but it also dives into cognitive biases and patterns of human thought, making it a really entertaining and educative exploration on how the human mind works. I hope that the Art of Science and Mathematics has helped you learn something new today. If you like this video, then like this video, subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you next week.